Hi, this is Elizabeth Huttinger with the 2020 Initiative. Our mission is to develop multidisciplinary projects that translate proven discoveries in health from the scientific community into practical solutions for developing nations. This is a status report on Projet-Crevette. Schistosomiasis is a parasitic worm disease affecting over 200 million people. Its most dreadful epidemic occurred in the West African nation of Senegal. The outbreak started in 1989. 25 years later, it remains unabated. The cause was a new dam that changed the ecosystem. The dam created an ideal habitat for the snail intermediate host and also decimated the predator of these snails, causing an epidemic. Throughout West Africa, transmission rates for schisto are very high. Africa alone has 97% of the world's cases. This is how you catch schisto. It starts on the left with the parasites or cerceri that burrow their way through human skin. These larvae move through the bloodstream to the lungs and eventually turn into this green worm, living in mating pairs in the veins of the intestine and the liver. There, they produce up to 1,000 eggs a day. Some eggs lodge in the liver, provoking critical damage. Others end up in the water supply, where they hatch and infect snails. Inside the snail, each infection ultimately produces 1,000 new cerceri every day that flood back into the river in search of the human host. Egg-laying schistosomes can also be found in the urinary system, in the lung, in the spinal cord, and even in the brain. Today, many villages still have an infection rate higher than 75% because the only available treatment is a drug that sadly does not prevent reinfection. So people are reinfected when they return to the water to do their laundry, to bathe, to collect water for the home, wash their animals, water their herds, and swim. This is the native river prawn that vanished above the dam in the late 1980s. Without this predator, the snail population exploded, and so did schistosomiasis. Freshwater prawns are well known for their snail consumption, eating up to one-third of their body weight every day. They eat snails most aggressively during their growth period. Prawns have a huge need for calcium to replace their body armature because they mold and grow new exteriors 14 times before they reach adult size. Pristine river water, on the other hand, is very poor in calcium. So the most concentrated source of calcium in the prawn's habitat are the shells of water snails that they hunt and devour. The goal of Projet-Crevette is to bring back the missing predator and see if rebalancing nature can eliminate schistosomiasis. We imported baby prawns from the Lobo River in Cameroon. This is what they looked like on arrival. Two pairs of villages were selected for their high infection rates. At half the sites, we treat the water with prawns, and the other sites are left alone. Here is one of our control sites. Control sites are left untouched, though the population has been properly consented and enrolled in the study, and they will receive better medical care than they do now. Here is one of our research sites where cages have been built to permit the natural flow of the habitat to keep the prawns on site eating snails. The research design is simple. We've treated 700 participants with the drug praziquantel, both test groups and control groups, to create a zero base of infection at the start. Then we return at 4, 8, and 12 months to test the population for schistosomiasis. We expect people protected by the prawns to have significantly lower rates of infection. The project involved over a year of preparation, mostly dialoguing with the villagers to share in the design of the protocol and really own the results. The flow-through fence was designed by local professionals. Dead weights and a heavy pole ground the mesh fence. We located it to enclose the tall grasses where the snails hide. Local villagers worked with a professional team, and once the enclosures were built, the prawns arrived a week later, and the entire village, even village chiefs and mothers, helped us release them into the water. At Pocotan, all the children came running down to the beach after school for a hands-on lesson in ecology. Once installed, it's back to business as usual for our study participants, who are mostly mothers and young children chosen because they're not likely to have any other water contact except in the enclosure for the next year. A secondary outcome of this project is that every 6 months, a sizable crop of giant prawns is produced by village women to either eat or sell. The local market price for freshwater prawns is about 5 times higher than the price of fish. Here is the partnership framework for Projet-Crevette. Our lead partner is the University of California at Santa Barbara. We coordinate with the Ministry of Health, the Ethics Committee on Human Research, the National Aquaculture Agency, and Gulf Aquatics. There are 38 team members working on this project on 3 continents, most of them with advanced academic degrees. If successful, we will scale it up to be a sustainable free-range fishery that can be applied wherever ecosystem changes, like dams, have caused schistosomiasis. Finally, let me report that the Dean of the Bren School of Environment Policy and Management at UC Santa Barbara said Projet-Crevette represents a new frontier in health, where ecosystem management is used as a public health intervention. He said the project will break new ground in ecology, public health, food security, and economics. I hope you'll continue to follow our exciting progress. This is a unique convergence of villagers, doctors, and scientists coming together and solving one of the largest challenges in global health. African bololen, ñu bolé xol yi ñu liggé. African bololen, ñu bolé xol yi ñu liggé. Africans in unite, Africans in unite. At home and abroad, let's shine our light. Africans in